Everyone, welcome back to BPO interview tutorials, and I hope you guys are doing really well. So today we came up with an interesting concept that is on what kind of quality feedbacks we can share to the employees and how we can convince the employee or how we can remove the negative feedbacks, or else if the employees are not accepting the feedback, what approach we can use. So we will learn this today. This is very important concept, guys. Please watch this video completely, don't skip it. Before moving to the video, I would request everyone to please share, subscribe the channel, click on bell icon so that you will get notification on all the upcoming video. Check out the playlist, there are approximately 200 plus videos that will help you in cracking your interview related to trainers, team leader, quality analyst, Six Sigma certification, WFM analyst, associates, many more videos are there. Let's start today's concept, that is on call center quality feedback examples. So why feedback is needed? So what is the main reason behind it? So guys, I hope you guys already started working on any of the organization wherein you have seen quality team will come, they will share the feedback on the audits what they have done. What we understand here is, okay, I did the mistake, that is the reason I'm getting the feedback. This is what mainly associates will think, but it has a big meaning on it. The feedback is not something which is just a information they are sharing to us. There are many things which are linked to it. Let's go and see what is the main importance about the feedback is. So see guys, if quality team is sharing the feedback on any of the error, and if you are improvising on those particular error, definitely the customer satisfaction will get increased. If customer satisfaction will get increased, the business will get increased. The business will get increased, for sure the headcount will get increased. We'll get more business and many things comes in picture as an opportunity, guys, for everyone. Okay, so this is the main reason. A constructive feedback, I can say a positive feedback is much needed. Okay, now this, if the CSAT is good, that is also a parameters for the employee. So that is the reason we will get all these things only and only if we are getting right feedback on a right time. So guys, this is the main reason, the customer satisfaction, mainly the for the customer satisfaction, customer in terms of our client satisfaction, the quality feedbacks are more important. What if you have started working on any of the calling, email or chat process, and it's almost now 2 to 3 months and no one have shared you an information what wrong you have done, what right you have done, what will happen? You will continue the same thing, and if anything big occurs, then you cannot blame to anyone there. So that is the reason feedbacks are very, very important in any of the organization. Let's move to the main topic, that is constructive feedback. So guys, constructive feedback is very, very important. Reason behind is, if a quality person is giving constructive feedback rather than shouting, using negative comments, sharing feedback in group, pointing to someone, if this is happening, definitely there will be a demotivation. So I always suggest everyone, see guys, errors may comes, okay, definitely we are humans, sometimes unintentionally we might do the error, and sometimes if there is a lack of process knowledge or there is a will issue, intentional errors will also be occurred. But there should be a way to tackle this out. We cannot just rush on it and we will lower down the morale of the employee. So that is the reason constructive feedback comes into picture. So we'll see the first point here, that is effective quality feedback is the critical tool for improving customer service and the call center efficiency. Yes, this is very, very important. You have to make sure that the efficiency will only get increased if the feedbacks are shared constructive to the employees. With the help of feedback, we can identify the root cause behind the issue and we can keep more focus on the future errors if there are anything. Okay, managers can identify the area where agent need the improvement so that they can focus on the service delivery, and they will also see what parameters are impacting a lot here. Managers can also inform to the training team on the feedbacks what are shared and what the observation they have received, so that a training team can conduct the sessions for the employees. Without naming any of the employee name, it will be a common feedbacks to everyone. And regular feedbacks on errors will help in improving the process knowledge for the employee so that they can not repeat the same error again. I always suggest one-on-one feedback will give you a great result rather than sharing feedback in front of all the employees. Might be it's a normal feedback or critical feedback or low-level feedback. Low-level in the sense it's just information. I would suggest if it is for some person, if you are going in person and sharing that, I would request everyone to please share feedback one-on-one so that employee will always feel motivated. And in group, we can just have a combined discussions on the errors, what entire team had made, without mentioning or without pointing to any of the employee. So these are the some ways of giving the constructive feedback. Let's move to the next point, that is what if you're not sharing the constructive feedback, what will be an issue there? So these are the basic issues what I personally identified, and I want to share this information with you all guys. So suppose the first thing will be decrease the morale of the employee, then demotivation, the person will repeat the mistake again, there will be a lack of process knowledge for sure, and motivation will be not there, and he will not be focused, efficiency will get reduced, there will be loss in the CSATs, and business will get impacted, for sure there will be a downfall in the company as well as for the employee performance. So this might comes if feedbacks are not shared properly or exactly with the employees. Let's move some of the positive feedback lines which you guys can use. I'm not going to read everything guys, you just check it out and see whatever helps you out in terms of sharing the feedback to the employees. For an example, like, great job, you have handled the customer issues so quickly and professionally. Your positive attitude and willingness to go to the extra mile for the customer is appreciated. Your patience and empathy is dealing with that frustrated customer was outstanding. Your ability to effectively de-escalate a tense situation and turn it to the positive experience for the customer is impressive. Many points guys, I'm not telling you to just read all this point in front of the employees. I'm just suggesting you guys to check out, learn from this so that you can go and tell the information in an effective manner. You can see many points are there. Your attention to the detail is ensuring that all the customers need what they were actually looking for, and this was very impressive. You were available to provide the personalized experience for the customer, which made them feel valued and important. So many points are there guys, and you can create your own points as well. Let's move some constructive feedback line. How can we give the constructive feedback? Your hold time was longer than the target of 30 seconds, example. Please work on answering call more quickly. So I hope you are understanding my point. Rather than I'm questioning here, why there is a long hold? Why you are not focusing there? What is the issue behind it? Are you chit-chatting to the nearby person, keeping the call on hold? So these all points are not required actually. If you felt this is what happening, do time and motion analysis. Sorry, not time and motion. Do real-time analysis. Do side-by-side audits. Check out if you are identifying any behavior issue from the employee. That also silently observe, and if you have anything, share feedback one-on-one rather than sharing feedback in group or in front of other employee. Second, you can see your tone of voice came across and uninterested and unfriendly. Please work on conveying more positive and your intention with the customer. So you can see these points are very, 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 very acceptable points I can say, and people will accept this definitely rather than taking feedback in a negative way. You did not follow the last point I'm reading out. You did not follow the established company protocol in handling the customer issue. Please review the protocol and ensure that you are following it consistently. Guys, you can use all this point. Check out this and definitely implement this in your all the upcoming audits or any of the feedbacks you guys are sharing out. Let's move a few more lines. You can see guys, there are a few more lines I have added. If you find these are valuable for you and yes, this is helping you out, then please definitely go with this. I'm telling guys, this is not only for the quality, it's for team leader, trainer, all the support functions who are going and sharing feedback to the employees. It's not even only on the audits, it's on anything at personal level also guys. You should utilize everything. Let's move to the another point. What are the other ways of sharing the feedback? So this approach, I'm telling you guys, if you're working as a quality analyst team leader, you should have some level of sharing the feedback. Okay, there are certain level implemented in Six Sigma also in terms of sharing the feedback. I would suggest follow those approach in terms of sharing the feedback so that your level will be improved actually. So the first, you can say, use the Eric model. What is this Eric model? So in terms of sharing the feedback, you should explain the behavior you have observed, explain the result on that behavior, check out, inquire about the perspective on the behavior and the result, and clarify what happened and check out if that will not impact in the future. This is one method you can implement whenever you go for a feedback. Second, data-driven approach. Data-driven approach, which means, suppose a person is not ready to accept the feedback, go and check out his previous data. See if the person have done the mistake same again. It's completely depend on the data. Do the RCA, identify like side-by-side audits, everything you can do to identify like either what is the actual issue happening here. You can also go with 3:1 ratio method. This is also one method wherein first you will go with positive comment, then again positive comment, then third positive comment. If you go with more positive comment, there will be one impression set for the employee that yes, I have done so many things right here. Now you are going with the constructive feedback. At the time, definitely the employee will accept, okay, this is a mistake I have done, but if I see I have taken that particular call or email or chat, 80% it was good, oh, because of this 20%, I found there is a mistake. So what I have done here, mistake was there, but I told more positive point to the employee. Then I went to the negative point, or else I can say the opportunity point here. So you can use this methodology also. Second, you can use smart technology. I just mentioned wrong here, SMART. So smart technology, which means S stands for specific, then measurable, achievable, realistic, and timely. I have already added a video for this. I will share the link in description. Just check out, guys, what is this approach. You can also use sandwich method. The video is added. I will share the link in the description, but sandwich method is very easy. First, we will explain what the strength you have identified over that particular call, what the best thing or what he had done there. Then we will go with the opportunity. Again, we will explain it about the strength. So what will happen, the opportunity point and the strength, whenever you will take in this way, definitely the employee will feel positive manner here. Conducting regular reviews, I already told you guys, it's self-explainable. So this is all about sharing the feedback in the constructive way when an employee is not ready to accept the feedback, or if you want to improve your feedback mechanism techniques, you can use all this approach. If you still have any doubt, let me know, guys. Definitely I will help you out and share your feedbacks and comments if you have felt like yes, this is interesting and yes, we have learned something new today. Also check out our Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook page. You will find all the information on the upcoming vacancies all over India so that you can try and crack your interview very easily. Still have any doubt? Just a message away. Please share me. Definitely I'll help you out, guys. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.